Welcome to another edition of Coonrod's Corner. Today's topic, the impact of environmental conditions on high-frequency circuit performance. Here's your host, John Coonrod.
Hello, welcome to Coonrod's Corner. My name is John Coonrod. I am a technical marketing manager for Rogers Corporation. I'm going to spend a few minutes today talking about environmental conditions that can impact high-frequency performance of printed circuit boards. To begin with, there are several potential issues in the environment that can cause circuit performance to deviate. Temperature and humidity both are some of that. First off, let's look at TCDK, which is thermal coefficient of dielectric constant, and essentially what that is how much the dielectric constant of the material will change with a change in temperature. There's also TCDF, which is analogous in the sense of DF. So TCDF is how much the DF, dissipation factor, will change with a change in temperature. So to begin with, let's look at the TCDK and how that affects the performance with a change in temperature. And here I've given a graph to explain this. So in the graph shown here, I have microstrip edge couple bandpass filters, and what I've done was normalize them at room temperature, about 23 degrees C, or 25 degrees C. And then after that, I would test the filters and I would change the temperature and look for a response and shift in frequency and record that. So that's essentially what this chart is showing. And you can see the material that is very well behaved for TCDK is the RT Duroid 6002 laminate and also the Rogers RO4350B laminate. The 6002 laminate has a TCDK of about 12 to 17, and the RO4350B laminate is about a 50 TCDK. Both of those numbers are considered very good for TCDK. Now, the other laminate that we're looking at here is a competitive material that is PTFE. It's a ceramic-filled PTFE, and it's got a TCDK of about 240, 250, and that's the green curve. And you can see there's quite a dramatic response for the shift in the center frequency of the bandpass filter as you change temperatures, whereas the other materials, there's a minor shift and really not that significant. TCDK and TCDF are really temperature related only, and the effects of humidity can be pretty significant. Humidity or water vapor really has a dielectric constant about 70, and when that is absorbed into a material, that's going to increase the dielectric constant of the material significantly. Also, the dissipation factor of the material will also increase as well, because water is very polar, so any kind of moisture that can be absorbed into the circuit will make a difference on insertion loss, phase response, and different electrical properties like that. There are several different ways to measure moisture absorption into printed circuit board laminates, and we're going to discuss some of those today. A few of them are a little bit unrealistic, however, they are a worst case scenario where we actually submerge the samples in water and actually in warm water. And then the other test we'll look at is called an 85-85 test, and what that means is 85 degrees C at 85% relative humidity. That's a little bit more realistic test. It is also considered pretty aggressive though. And these tests are really looking at the raw materials being tested and not in circuit form. On the table of information shown here, I'm showing two different materials being evaluated for moisture absorption. The first one is the ceramic-filled PTFE-based material, which is Rogers RO3003 laminate. The other material is a new material on the market that's a competitive material. It's really PPE-based, and it's a thermal set material. Now, the nice thing about this comparison is these two materials are very significantly different for their formulation. However, you can see their dielectric constant is also very similar. The dissipation factors are different, but this still makes for a pretty good comparison of how these materials behave with different moisture exposure. First off, the 23 degrees C and 50% RH, that row is really our baseline. So we condition all samples at room temperature, 50% RH for several days, and that's our baseline. And then from there, we note the changes. And one of the things we did was look at desiccating the material, or basically making sure it's completely dry, 0% humidity. And what you find there normally is that the dissipation factor should drop. As you dry out the material and remove moisture from the material, the dissipation factor should drop, which it does. So it looks like this test is behaving the way it should. And then also the dielectric constant should go down a little as well. Again, it does when both these materials are desiccated. Now looking at the humidity testing, the worst case scenario here is water submersion. One of these tests at 24 hours at room temperature water, and one of them is 48 hours at 50 degrees C water. These are not real realistic tests, however, they are pretty aggressive. And what you want to do is compare the differences between the baseline 23 degrees C and 50% RH to these water submersion tests. And the dielectric constant really doesn't change too much on these materials. However, dissipation factor does. And you can see the dissipation factor for the RO3003 materials baseline is about 0.0014. And then after water submersion at 24 hours at 23 degrees C, it goes up to 0.0021. So that is a difference. It's not a significant difference, but it is obviously a difference. And then you can see the difference at 48 hours, it goes up to 0.0024. Now, a more realistic test is 85 degrees C, 85% RH, and this time it was extended out to 72 hours. And you can see the difference in dissipation factor is 0.0014 to 0.0018. And that's really not that significant of a difference, but it is interesting to know how the other materials, the PPE-based materials, behave. So when you look at these same conditions, baseline dissipation factor for the PPE-based material, you get a dissipation factor of about 0.0036, and after 24 hours of water submersion, it goes up significantly to 0.0057, and the 48 hours at 50 degrees C water, that goes up to 0.0075. These are pretty dramatic changes. And then if you look at the more realistic test, the 72 hours at 85-85, the baseline of 0.0036 dissipation factor, going up additional 0.001 to 0.0046, that's pretty significant. And then if you look at the moisture absorption numbers themselves, the RO3003, depending on the conditions, is usually 0.011 or less. In the case of the PPE materials, they're about 3 to 5 times different and much more higher for moisture absorption. Now let's take a look at how moisture absorption affects circuit performance. The previous data was really looking at raw substrate being tested with different humidity conditions. Now let's look at a circuit being conditioned with different humidity levels and then what the circuit performance is. So the graph shown here is actually a microstrip insertion loss comparison of these two different materials, the RO3003 materials and the competitive PPE material. And to begin with, the orange curve is the RO3003 laminate, the circuits made on that laminate, conditioned at room temperature, 23 degrees C, 50% RH. And you can see the comparison between that and the blue curve of that same circuit after being conditioned 72 hours at 85-85, there's not much difference. So for insertion loss at 79 gigahertz, there's a difference of about 0.1 dB per inch. So the RO3003 is pretty stable, even with a pretty aggressive test like the 85-85 testing. The competitive PPE materials responded much more dramatic, and you can see at 79 gigahertz, the PPE materials actually changed insertion loss of, has a difference actually of 0.8 dB per inch at 79 gigahertz, so about 8 times more dramatic than what the RO3003 materials did. Now moisture absorption affects more than just insertion loss, it actually affects phase response as well and how the circuit's going to behave for effective dielectric constant. Now what I have shown here is a chart showing dielectric constant versus frequency. This chart is showing microstrip differential phase length testing on the same materials as the previous chart, and the 5 mil RO3003 materials made in circuit form, microstrip transmission line, you can see the difference between the room temperature testing, room temperature conditioning, and the conditioning in 85-85. There's very little difference here. For a dielectric constant at 79 gigahertz, there's a difference of 0.005, which is pretty insignificant. Now, as for the competitive PPE materials at 79 gigahertz, there is a much more dramatic change, and there is a difference of 0.04 for the dielectric constant at that frequency. Again, it's about a difference of 8 in magnitude between how these circuits and how these materials perform to these different conditions. This concludes another session of Coonrod's Corner. Thank you for watching.
For additional information and technical tools, if you are not already a member, join the Rogers Technology Support Hub and gain access to calculators, technical papers, and more of Coonrod's Corner and other informational videos. Rogers Technical Information is also available at your fingertips with the Rog mobile app, available for the iPhone, iPad, and Android devices. Check it out today.